hosting our story. Like, Jazz did such a great job. I'm really thankful for KP because it's one of the few places where, as so many have mentioned before me, where I can really unapologetically be queer and be just express myself without fear of like people thinking that I'm lesser than them or just having people accept me for who I am. And being queer is a part of who I am, and I'm happy that you all accept me because of that. Like, thank you so much. And I mentioned that because KP is 30 years old now, and that's amazing. Like, we're 30 years old, and throughout that time, things have changed so much. This org started out with a few Filipino guys who just wanted to pick up chicks, right? Like, that's literally how this org started. A bit of KP history for everyone. And now we're here talking about social justice. We're talking about including people. We're talking about access and retention, and we've gone so far from just picking up chicks and hooking people up. We are here because so many before us have put so much hard work into this space. They put everything that they had into this space because they knew how much an impact being a mentor or a femtor is to somebody else. That's why I'm so thankful for my kuyas and atas, because they're really the ones who introduced such a huge world to me. Because of them, I'm where I am now, and because of them, I'm doing a lot of good work for community. And it's humbling, but it's also a privilege to be here, to be a part of this space, to feel like there are other people who care about me and who actually see me for who I am. That is truly a gift and an opportunity, and I'm so thankful that everybody in this room is here today celebrating each other, celebrating our history. And I want us to focus on the fact that it is our history, not just history, because often we do marginalize women, trans people, especially queer people, out of narratives. And the fact that we're focusing on